We're going to talk about the cause of seasons. And here we see an image of the Earth orbiting around the Sun. The first thing to notice is the tilt of Earth's axis and how that tilt always stays oriented in the same direction. So as Earth orbits the Sun, the tilt doesn't change and the direction of the tilt doesn't change. But what does change is the orientation of that tilt relative to the Sun. Let's start with the summer solstice. On the summer solstice, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the Sun. Notice the shadow line. This shows how much of the Earth is in shadow and how much is in sunshine. First, notice the North Pole is not in shadow at all. That means that at the North Pole, they will be receiving continuous sunshine on the summer solstice. Now look at the northern hemisphere and the amount that is in shadow versus the amount that is in sunshine. A much larger portion is in sunshine than in shadow. What that means is that the nights are going to be short and the days are going to be long. Now let's look at the winter solstice. Again, we've got Earth's tilt going in the same direction, but now the axis is tilted away from the Sun. And now look at the shadow line. Here we see that the North Pole is in shadow. That means it will be continuously in shadow, and the North Pole will have continuous darkness. Now for the northern hemisphere, notice that more is in shadow than is in light. That means that the nights are going to be long and the days are going to be much shorter. And then we have the two equinoxes. On either equinox, the tilt is neither towards nor away from the Sun, but at a right angle to the Sun. Notice that the shadow line goes from the North Pole to the South Pole at both equinoxes. That means that the Earth is half illuminated and half in darkness evenly from the North to South Pole, so that all parts of the Earth will experience equal amounts of daytime and nighttime, so the days and nights are equal. Now, one of the rules of seasons is that the longer you are in daytime, the hotter it's going to be because you are receiving sunlight for a longer period of time. So at the summer solstice, you're going to experience more daytime. It's going to get warmer. At the winter solstice, less daytime, colder. At the fall and spring equinoxes, equal amount of time of day and night, so a more regulated amount of heat, neither hot nor cold. The other factor affecting seasons is the intensity of sunlight. In the summer, the Sun shining onto the Earth will shine directly onto the latitude of 23.5 degrees north. Well, that's relatively close to North America, which means the Sun is going to be not quite overhead, but very high in the sky, and the sunlight will be very intense. At the winter solstice, the Sun is shining directly onto the latitude of 23.5 degrees south of the equator. Notice that that is much farther from North America. The Sun is not going to be nearly as high in the sky, and so the sunlight is going to be less intense. At the equinoxes, the Sun shines directly over the equator. So from our point of view, it's neither going to be at its highest point, which it is in the summer, or at its lowest point, which it is in the winter, but somewhere halfway in between. Again, not nearly as intense as it is in the summertime, not nearly as low intensity as it is in the wintertime, but somewhere in between. And that intensity also affects the temperature. The more intense the light, as it is in the summer, the hotter the sunlight is going to feel. The less intense the light, as it is in the winter, the cooler the sunlight is going to feel. And it's going to be somewhere in between at the two equinoxes.